I wrote Brave in a at the tail end of basically a long season. I wrote it basically after 28 years of struggling with fear. I wanted to be taken into the deeper places. I didn't want to just stay at the shallow end where it was comfortable and safe for me. I wanted to be in the depths. I wanted to be overtaken by His love, by just a deeper revelation of who God is. So for me, I basically it was about writing myself into that story, writing myself into that picture, and giving language to the invitation that I was feeling from Him at the time. When I sing Brave now, I'm giving myself permission to embrace the things that I have been afraid of. The greatest anthems aren't about even lyrics and melody, they're about, was somebody willing to say yes in the face of opposition? Was somebody willing to embrace the revolution that's inside of them first, even when nobody else was looking, and it got hard and it got messy, and they still said yes? The reward of saying yes is greater than the regret of saying no.
I can't thank you enough. My love the fact that when Jesus died on the cross, it meant we could come before him with boldness. Because when that veil was torn in two, it gives us this access. It gives us this moment, these moments that we live for, that his presence comes and hovers and we can feel it. Aren't you so thankful for Jesus? Aren't you so thankful for the price that he paid on the cross to pay for our sin and give us mercy and grace? But more than that, I love that he wanted us. He wants us. He loves to be with us. Will you lift your hands for a moment? I just want you to tune into that for a moment of just saying, God, I thank you for the cross. There's no one like you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We press into you tonight, Lord. We love your presence. We love you. We love you.
Thank you.
We sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. The Lamb is overcome. We sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. The Lamb has overcome. We sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah, the Lamb has overcome. We sing hallelujah, oh we sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah, the Lamb has overcome. We sing.
A little bit younger, I just remember asking God, like, I always want to believe what I sing, where you're so in love with God and you so are grounded in who he is that no matter what happens to you, you can still say it's well with my soul just because of who he is. The song came out of a couple different moments. Me and my husband were looking for a house, and it was just this long process, long drawn out process. And I just remember being like, oh, God, I'll never get a house. We'll never get a house. We tend to be really short-sighted sometimes, and the problem that's right in front of us tends to be the biggest thing in the world. And he was just very kind and kind of saying, hey, I've done some bigger things than this before. Like, this really isn't that big of a problem. And so I sat down and I wrote the first verse, a grander earth has quaked before. From that place of just experiencing that awakening kind of my heart, I started to sing differently, because when I would sing about God being faithful, I realized that, oh, I know that he's faithful now. To encounter the faithfulness of God is not always a comfortable thing, because you have to be in a place where you actually need somebody to be faithful to you, and that's usually uncomfortable. But God actually created us not to live apart from him and apart from everything that he is. I realized that I just needed to, and I needed to not despise my need of God. The chorus of the song, let go my soul and trust in him. The waves and winds still know his name. And we've heard the story about how Jesus was on the boat and, you know, he woke up and he's like, why are you so afraid? And then he calms the storm. I think anything in life is kind of like that wind and that waves that one day, anything they will ever face. And I bet you everything knows his name. I bet you that everything we'll ever face has already tasted some level of defeat, or the entirety of defeat, because of what he did. And so there's really nothing to be afraid of. The addition of the hymn was actually my husband's idea. Everybody at some point in their life can really connect with that hymn. And then when I got to the recording of You Make Me Brave, I just suggested it to the producer. He's like, yeah, let's do it, but let's not tell the band. It just became this amazing, spontaneous moment at the recording, actually. My prayers for the song and what I've seen it do already is just to comfort people in really, really deep and hard times, the disappointments and the disillusionment, you know, and gets us to shake off self-pity for the rest of our lives. He really encountered me when I needed him the most. And I needed rescue, I needed salvation, I needed faithfulness, and he came through for me. So now my faith is faith, and it's not just hope. We can hope that God's real our whole lives, you know, but why not know that he's real?
Trust in him, the waves and wind still. There's a sound about to come out of this place tonight. Come on, every woman, every mother, lift your voice. Come on, breakthrough's happening right now. I can feel it in the atmosphere. Sing from your spirit. Hey!
Step into all you have for us. Sing it, we step. You are beautiful. just like a child, staring at the beauty of our King. Steady me, slow and sweet, we sway, take the lead, and I will follow. Finally ready now to close my eyes and just believe that you won't lead me where you don't go. When my faith gets tired and my hope seems lost, you spin me round and round and remind me of that song, the one you wrote for me. And we dance, and we dance. Pick up my sword and fight for love. Little did I know that love had won for me. Here in your arms, you're still my heart again. I breathe you in like I've never breathed till now. When my faith gets tired and my hope seems lost, you spin me around and around and remind me of that song, the one you wrote for me.
Not alone, I've found my home here in your arms.